In AppSheet, there are a couple of machine learning powered tools that an app developer could utilize to enhance the experience of their application. So in this video, I'll be going through the three machine learning powered tools that are offered in AppSheet in the point of view of a hypothetical manufacturing company that is called ABC Co. So ABC Co manufactures custom robotic solutions for their customers. And they're very interested in leveraging the power of machine learning to enhance and also increase the efficiency of their workflow. So, without further ado, let's jump straight into the first tool, which is predictive models. So, with predictive models, you can actually create custom machine learning models in your AppSheet application. And this is actually powered by Google Cloud's machine learning engine. So, what this means for you as an application developer is that the algorithms and also the training of the machine learning models will be done for you by the engine. All you have to do is to provide the data set, state the output to be predicted, and also the inputs that might be of influence to this output as well. In this scenario, ABC Co could make use of the historical data to make predictions as well. So one of the data sets that they have currently is the cost data set, which has records of the manufacturing jobs that they have completed for the customers with relevant details like the labor hours, the quantity, the complexity, and the cost of the job. Now, with this data set and the power of machine learning, the prediction of the cost of future manufacturing jobs could actually be achieved. So now let's go back to the AppSheet UI and start on the setup of our new predictive model. So the first thing that you have to set is the training data table, which for this case is the cost data set. Next, we have the column to predict, which is once again the column of the manufacturing jobs in the future. One thing to take note for this particular column is that only certain data types will be accepted. So these data types will be things like your yes/no data type, your enumerated data type, and also any kind of numeric data type. Any other data types other than the one that I've mentioned earlier on will not be accepted and will result in the machine learning model not being created. So lastly, we have the model inputs to set. So these are basically columns that are relevant or influential to your prediction problem. So for this case, I'll only require three columns, which will be the labor hours, the quantity, and the complexity of the job. So let me remove the ID column. And with that, we are actually done with the setup of the machine learning model. Once you click on Save, the training of the model will commence and it will take a few minutes to be completed. So for this video, I've already created a predictive model earlier on and in similar fashion to what we have just done a moment ago. And this is essentially what you will see once the training has been completed. So you will have things like the model summary, which will show the training status and also the model performance, which shows how accurate your model is. And you also have a few options that you could enable over here. They even provide you with the formula if you'd like to use it in your table as well. So now to see this predictive model in action, let's move over to the emulator on the right, which shows the view of the cost data set. So now let's click on the Add Overlay button over here to open up the form, and you can see the respective columns, your labor hours, your quantity, your complexity, and also the cost of the manufacturing job. Now, when I make any kind of changes to the three columns above, you can see that the cost will change. So if I change the labor hours, the cost will change respectively. If I change the quantity, let me increase it. It will change as well. And lastly, if I were to change the value of the complexity to say 1, it will show a certain value. And if I were to change it to 2, again, it will show another value and 3 as well. So this is how the predictive model will work in your app if you do decide to make use of it. Now, the next machine learning powered tool that we will go through will be the OCR models. So before we start with the setting up of the OCR model, we will first have to prepare the sample data set from which this OCR model will train on. So what I've done is to create a data set called invoice. So in ABC Co, we'll be using the OCR technology to scan an image of an invoice and then extract the relevant details of it, which will be reflected in the columns of the data set you see over here. So it'll be things like the invoice ID, the date, the item, and the quantity of the item itself. Now, all the way at the end, we have the image column, which stores the path to the image of the invoices of this sample data set. Now, with that being done, we will go back to the AppSheet UI and start on the setup of our OCR model. So we'll first select the table, which for this case is the invoice. The image column is basically the column that we've seen earlier on that stores the path to the image of the invoices for the sample data. And then we also have to select the output columns. So for this case, AppSheet has smartly selected for me the columns that I would like to extract out, which is the invoice ID, the date, and the following items and quantity of the items as well. Now, with all that being done, that's pretty much all you need to do to set up the OCR model. Once I click save, the training will begin. And what will happen is once it's completed, this is what you will see. So you will see that it will show the patterns that were found in the training examples. So if I were to click on one of the images of the invoice, you can see that the OCR technology was able to extract the correct details. So it'll be things like the date, the invoice ID, the items, and their quantity as well. So to see this in action, once again, let's go to the emulator of the AppSheet. Let's go out of this and go to the invoice tab. Now let's say I'd like to try to insert a new invoice, right? So let's click on the add overlay button over here. And if I scroll down, there'll be an option for me to upload the image. So right now, all the other columns are empty, right? Now let's see what will happen once we upload the image. So let's say I'd like to upload this invoice. And you can see within a few moments, every single column is filled up with the correct details. And with that, you know, we can easily and quickly extract text out of images or documents like invoices for this particular case, which greatly reduces the time that is required to get this kind of details. I mean, imagine doing it using the manual way. Now it's all automatically done for you within a matter of seconds. Now we go to the last machine learning powered tool in AppSheet, which is the Smart Assistant. The Smart Assistant is just like your Google Assistant on your mobile phone. So you can use your voice to interact with the application itself. Now to do that, you can just simply enable it under the Smart Assistant tab, and you can even change the language or locale used by the Smart Assistant. So for this case, since I'm based in Singapore, and I'm a Singaporean myself, let's click on English Singapore. And then we go over to the application, and under the hamburger menu, you have the assistant over there. So let's click on it, and they'll open up this page where it will prompt for you to give your voice commands. So for this case, let's try something like, you know, searching for an invoice from a certain date. So show me an invoice from the date of 1st of January 2021. And voila, just like that, it shows us, and or rather it returns us the invoice where the date is the 1st of January 2021. So let's try one more voice command to show the rows where the cost of manufacturing is above $10,000. Show me the rows from the manufacturing cost table where the cost is more than $10,000. And you can see over here, even validated from this text, which says view a table of cost rows where cost is more than 10,000. And if I scroll down under the cost column, you can see that all the cost is above $10,000. And with that, we've gone through all three of the machine learning powered tools in AppSheet and how you can utilize them to better enhance the experience of your application.